This is Alex Cohn and Alan here, and we are going to have a little commentary on the videos. It is July 9, 2003, and this is from Brooklyn, New York.
Brooklyn, New York, Prospect Park, approximately 1950, maybe 48 or 49. It's hard to tell the exact years by looking at these pictures
and
to get our exact ages. That's myself and my sister Alice fooling around in the grass, and my mother standing there worrying that we shouldn't hurt ourselves because we're really fighting, it looks like. Ha ha ha. And we're having a picnic in Prospect Park. This is Esther Cohen, my mother, Alexander and Cindy's grandmother on the Cohen side, handing out our lunch in Prospect Park on that day. Okay. Alice is eating, looks like she's having a good time. There's Daddy, he's eating also, Arthur. And Mother, of course, is going to make jokes and fool around. Well, it looks like we're getting ready to go home. Picnic is over, the day is coming to an end. Okay, I guess we didn't go home, we went to get drinks at the stand. So the picnic is not over yet. This dog was an Airedale, which was a neighbor of Aunt Rose and Uncle Irving on East 4th Street in Brooklyn.
Who's this?
This is Aunt Phyllis. There she is waving to us all. And that is Alice again and Aunt Rose walking back to their house. That is Uncle Irving with a big cigar in his mouth, which he always had, and petting the dog that belongs to the neighbor's house, is where he is standing now. Okay, now we're back in White Lake, where this is bungalow number 2, which was finished in 1952, which gives us an idea of the timeline here. Well, it looks like we're playing croquet out on the lawn behind the bungalows.
That was Aunt Alice there, right?
Yes, that was Aunt Alice hitting the ball. And there's Grandma Esther. Next.
So who are these people again?
Okay, this is that's myself, and Alice and Phyllis are also here, and my mother, Esther. We got good pictures of their feet and the balls and the clubs, but that's about it. Now, of course, the pictures are getting kind of faded because these movies are so very old, and were converted to tape at one time, and now being put onto DVD forever lasting. This is the farmer who built the bungalows for us. His name is Alfred Myers, and the road behind him is Route 17B. We are all getting ready to walk to White Lake, being that my father is in the city working. So that's Grandma Esther, Alice, Phyllis, and of course myself, who was taking the movies. Now the mailman just passed by, and I guess we're getting our mail now. Our mail from him. This is my father, Arthur Cullen, Alexander's grandfather, who we never met because he passed away in 1968. And these are the fields, and that's the old bungalow again. And again, we have faded movies due to their age. Okay, there's my father, Arthur. There's Alice and Esther, my mother Esther, sitting there. And there's Alice, again, she's raking the lawn for whatever it needed or not. And myself with a shovel, looking strong and whatever. And
that's a rake.
That's a rake.
Yes.
You're right there, Alice, it's a rake. I guess we had a very small garden, so I didn't need a lot of raking. Okay. Target practice with a BB gun. Naturally, we probably all hit bullseyes. Whether we really did or not is another story. But I guess it looks nice like that. I'm taking my turn now. A little bit of fun, being pushed in the hammock and of course dumped out after a few minutes. We all had a little fun having a good time. And my father's here with his shovel, and we had a friend up for the weekend, I believe, and this is my father's friend, Sydney.
We are now recording.
We are now recording, and the dog's name is Dusty, who belonged to the farmer and always came around because we played with him a lot. Okay, it looks like a cat back there. We missed whatever it was. Now, this is Alfred Meyer, and there's Alice, and we're haying with him in the fields. We're collecting all the hay after it was cut to be thrown on the truck and taken to the barn and being stuffed in the hayloft to feed the cows during the winter. As the movie progresses, we will see the action.
Thank you. Go ahead.
Now, this is a very interesting boat. This was an old lifeboat. Somehow, some way, it got onto White Lake. And a lot of the boys that were older than I was at this time were my sister Phyllis's friends, including Marty Rovinsky, who she eventually married when she was 21. This boat was always a lot of fun. The guys would,
what's the name of the boat?
The boat was called the African Queen. Now, here I am, Sister Alice, rowing in a rowboat that belongs to Rose and Stanley Williams on White Lake. We were visiting them because they were friends of my father's. And he gave us the boat to row around a little bit in. Notice we didn't wear any life jackets or anything. So now, here's my father rowing with Alice in the boat. I guess I'm taking the pictures. Okay, I'm in the boat with Shirley Williams, Rose and Stanley's daughter, and we were just rowing around in circles. The lake was so beautifully and calm then, but of course, the quality of the film depleted over the years. This is Stanley Williams, the proprietor of the property, and he is getting ready to mop out one of the boats to clean the water out of it, I guess. And later on in the picture, he will be taking us for a ride in a motorboat with a small outboard motor on it. Okay, there's Stanley taking us for a ride. Notice how peaceful the lake is. Hardly any boats out of those years. Nothing like what we left before we came out here to Arizona. Here are just some snap clips of cats running around, Alice by my mother's garden, Alfred Meyer helping us with the garden, pulling weeds, and little things that were going on around the house. Now we have cousins of my mother, Ray and Rebecca, who came to visit. And we're all picking blueberries on the farmer's property way down behind the barn. I am there with my mother and Alice and Phyllis. And we had quite a crop of blueberries, which turned into pies and cakes and whatever else we felt like baking. And this is our cousin, Dr. Samuel Schmerzler, who was a cousin on my mother's side. Also weekend visitors we enjoyed having once in a while. And of course the game we're playing is croquet. And this is his wife, Anna. Okay, this is Alice with a bathing cap and Phyllis swimming in White Lake off a pier that belonged to Winnick's bungalow colony. We paid them a few dollars to be able to swim off their property.
Which side of the lake was that on?
This is on the White Lake side, which is right off 17B.
By Rosie's apartment place?
A little ways closer to our bungalow than Rosie's place, than Rosie Williams' place. So here's just a few pictures of us splashing around in the water. These pictures were taken up, I believe, in the Sunset Park Avenue of Brooklyn.
What year?
In the year has to be someplace in the early 60s, late 50s, maybe early 60s, possibly. Prospect Park in, Sunset Park in Brooklyn, just romping around with the dog. Okay, here we are back up at White Lake in the land behind the bungalows. There's a little fence they're keeping the cows away, and the dog, of course, has to come back and bark at them, so they kind of get scared and run. Why they're